my channel. So this is going to be a February pick a card reading. So you can pick from pile 1, 2, and 3. I'm gonna put the timestamps in the comment section down below. So yeah, and if you haven't already, subscribe to my channel, hit the bell button so you know when I post any of my content, and feel free to follow me on Instagram. Okay, so let's hop straight into the reading. So hello, group one. So you got card number 7, Fated Meeting. With that you have the 9 of Swords, the Knight of Wands, and the Wheel of Fortune. I'm gonna go through after I'm done laying out all the cards and clarify each card with the Mystic Monday's Tarot deck. All right, so you have Hope, Archangel Hanael, all right, Archangel Metatron Mercy, Archangel Zaphkiel Ecstasy. You have Sarasvati, the Arts, Express Yourself Through Creative Activities. You have White Terra, Sensitivity. You're becoming increasingly sensitive. Avoid harsh relationships, environment, situations, and chemicals. And you have Maeve, Cycles and Rhythms. Honor the cycles of your body, energy levels, and emotions. All right. You have card number 34, Massage. You have card number 16, Make an Altar. And card number 6, Build Strength. You have card number 35, Storm Angel, Collisions of Beliefs, Styles, Attitudes, and Energies. And then we will read this at the end. Okay. So, damn, I don't have the book out. I need to read Fated Meeting. Well, I don't really need to. I could just look at it. Oh, this is gonna be cool. Okay, so, cause I usually read from the book for these, but I'm just gonna read this intuitively now and collectively. So, I feel like for some of you guys, this month of February, you'll be meeting somebody, okay? Valentine's Day. I see why. Okay, I tried to film this one other time before. I tried to film this like 2 days ago and I couldn't get into it. So I feel like it's because I was supposed to read, not read from the book for any of these. Okay. They said I'm ready. All right, you guys are ready. You guys are ready for love, okay? There's also something about maybe somebody that you had a fated meeting with. What am I getting from this? Okay. All right, so with that, we have the 9 of Swords, the Knight of Wands, and the Wheel of Fortune. For some of you, okay, there might have been somebody that left and is cycling back around, or maybe in this lifetime or in a past life, you guys maybe were separated and you prayed to always find one another again. I'm getting Nucleus. Okay. It's like whenever this person is gone, it upsets you or you get anxiety. For some of you guys, this person or you are in and out. Okay, let's go a bit deeper. Let's see what the 9 of Swords is talking about for you guys from my group one. What is this fated meeting talking about? Also, I'm getting that you guys will be meeting somebody that you've prayed for, or you have met somebody that you prayed for. Okay. I'm seeing a lot of funny stuff here. Sorry. We'll get to it all later on. But yeah, let's see what the Nine of Swords is talking about. Yeah, I'm getting this is a brand new cycle for you guys. Maybe a new cycle in love. You have the King of Wands. Ooh, the Two of Cups. I don't know if I want to keep that. I mean, it came out. It's the only card that came out. So shit. The Chariot. So I'm getting that there could have been somebody that you're anxious to move forward with in a romantic sense with the Three of Swords. I don't know if it's somebody that, hairs everywhere. Okay, so we have the Fool. I don't know if it's someone you were supposed to move forward with, but because something happened, like you had to be solo. Princess of Swords. Or, well, this is the Page of Swords. So. I also see you guys moving forward from heartache or like something that was painful, like a painful situation. Okay. What is this Princess of Swords? Okay, we have the Two of Wands. So this is a path here. I feel like some of you guys are choosing a better path. Four of Swords. I'm getting like a path of healing. Okay, some of you guys are not talking to someone. Okay. And that's just part of the path. You guys need to meditate on something, or you needed to meditate on something here. I get you guys are choosing different. Okay. Or maybe choosing differently is giving you anxiety. This is something different I'm getting. Something you're not used to. Excuse me. Yeah, with the Page of Swords. We have the Two of Swords, so somebody was confused or somebody is confused. That's why they're in and out. With the Ace of Pentacles, this is confused about offering something to somebody. Oh my God. We have the Lovers here. So somebody is torn between two. Okay, so somebody met somebody. I'm getting somebody is somebody's soulmate. Okay, they vibrate. Whoever this person is, they vibrate pretty high. We have the Seven of Wands. Okay, so there's competition here. There's, there's juggling. This is a messy situation. Somebody is confused. Somebody was in and out, or you. This could be you. Take it how it resonates. Somebody was juggling somebody. Okay. Somebody wanted to offer somebody something, but somebody was, it's like somebody was standing in the way. This is making somebody confused. We have the Six of Cups. Soulmate energy. Again, with the Four of Cups. So what is the Four of Cups? Oh shit. What's the Four of Cups? Because I am getting like somebody's getting something here. We have the Three of Wands. Somebody is waiting on somebody. It's like somebody's secretly praying for somebody to come in that may have left. Okay. We have the Ace of Swords, so someone could also be waiting on like a text or a call, or like you feel like somebody is gonna text you or call you, or someone's not gonna text you or call you. Okay, but this is for someone as well that knows that it's like somebody tried to juggle you. So if you're the one that was being juggled, you're not texting or calling nobody. Like, they're probably gonna text or call you, right? But their energy is still very it's not stable. Man, I know a lot of you guys are looking for stability. And I feel like some of you guys had to withdraw from a situation, or maybe like a path or a journey, because of instability. Why did my voice shake like that? It was almost like mental instability as well. So what's the Great Wheel, the Wheel of Fortune? Nine of Swords again. What is this anxiety here? Someone is anxious about change, anxious about leaving a cycle, okay? That's why they keep coming in and out, going back and forth. They're going back and forth with themselves. And I wouldn't be surprised if the Five of Wands came out. We have Judgment. Somebody knows that they have to walk through the doors, right? Somebody knows they have to walk through the doors. Basically the doors of value, okay? Ten of Wands, because somebody's been carrying a lot of shit. Even shit that's not even theirs. Shit that's not even theirs. We have the Six of Pentacles here, okay? It's time for equal giving and receiving. It's time for stability with the Four of Pentacles, okay? Oh shit. Ooh, Pile One, y'all are speaking to me today. Y'all are speaking to me today. All right, we have the Knight of Swords. So I'm getting, okay, rushing in, speaking truth. We have the Hierophant here. It's like some of you guys know that this is what you want. Your issue is, right? Can you do this? What are people gonna say? It hasn't been traditionally done this way. Or some of you guys could be worried about companies coming after you, or like the feds coming for you, or like the government coming for you, or something. This is hindering some of y'all from walking through the door. I'm getting the door of value, okay? I'm getting you're not a pack mule. Shit. Knight of Wands wanted to come out again. So is there anything else you would like to say? We have the Queen of Wands. Somebody sees something clearly now. Mm-hmm. Someone sees something clearly, or someone is seeing you clearly now. Maybe they're seeing what you have said, okay? Maybe somebody is watching you, okay? Or maybe you're watching somebody. Take it how it resonates. Take this how it resonates, right? I also am getting that once you go through these doors, some of you guys are anxious about the work it's gonna take to get what it is that you want, to gain the stability here, okay? But you're overthinking it. It's not gonna be that hard. Okay. At the bottom of the deck, we have the King of Pentacles. So, yeah. This is boss energy. Faded. Wow. Okay. So, we have Archangel Hanayel, Hope. We have mercy, we have ecstasy. Yeah, I showed this to you guys already. All right, so what am I getting from this though? Whatever or whoever this is, right? I'm getting that some of you guys hoped, wished, and prayed for somebody here. With the mercy card, it's like you've been gifted something or you've been granted something. It's like you knew you would always be able to find somebody like this. You've always hoped for it, right? Some of you guys may have gone through like some fucked up situations in the past, but it's like you've been granted mercy. It's like, have mercy on your soul. It's like, yes, God, have mercy on my soul. And you've been granted that mercy. And now with the ecstasy card, it's like this person, whoever this is, like look how this person is laid back. It's like, fuck, they look mind blown, like in every way, like they're mind blown. They're like, what? Like, this person makes me feel like this even without sex. Like, this person makes you feel like this. This is somebody that you were fated to meet. Okay, so we have Sarasvati, the arts, express yourself through creative activities. So I feel like a lot of you guys are very creative. This month you guys probably will be very, 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 very creative. We have white tarot sensitivity, so some of you guys may be super sensitive this month, okay? For others of you guys, you may be coming out of a relationship that may not have been the best for you. Or maybe this is like energy from the past that you're dealing with here. And you're realizing that something just wasn't for you. Okay, maybe some of you guys had to numb yourselves to be with somebody or something like that. And then you have May of Cycles and Rhythms. Honor the cycles of your body, energy levels, and emotions. So somebody's being called to like listen to the how they're feeling, how their bodies are feeling. Maybe create something out of those emotions, okay? Maybe create art out of those emotions. Okay, so we have card number 35, Storm Angel Collision. Of beliefs, styles, attitudes, and energies. So with this card right here, the energy of like the breaking up, you know, it was because y'all didn't believe in the same things, okay? Or maybe this was in the past, that the reason why some of you guys weren't in healthy situations or healthy relationships was because your beliefs collided. The way y'all did things were different, like how y'all acted was super different. Y'all's energies was just not in sync, okay? Y'all's energies was not in sync. They were not in tune. All right, so let's see how you guys can take care of yourselves this month. So it's looking like you guys need a massage, okay? You Yeah, y'all need a massage. So Valentine's Day is coming up. I'm sure they have some massage specials or some shit. If they don't, they do. Or they should. Alright, so we have make an altar. So some of you guys may need to really connect with your altar if you have one. If you don't have one, create one. This is the month to do so. Especially with all the energies of love. It's good to connect with, like, you know, the loving energies of the ones that were before you, even just if it's yourself or like a deity, right? And then you have card number six, build strength. So some of you guys may be working out or you need to work out this month, okay? Even if it's just at home, that's still something. All right, and then you have this girl here. It says, stand in a garden and be thought free just for a moment. Four of Swords energy. Beautiful. All right. I love you guys so much. I hope that this resonated with y'all. And I will talk to y'all later. What's up, group two? So let's see what you guys got for the week. Or the month of February. We have the Two of Keys, the treasure. We have the Four of Wands. We have the Queen of Swords. And you have the Three of Pentacles. So at the end of all of this, I was laughing in group one earlier. I was like, I'm probably like supposed to read these like intuitively because I didn't take out any of the books. So I had done group ones and everything, and like, and that's exactly what I was supposed to be doing. Like, exactly. All right, so we have Archangel Raphael, empathy. You have Archangel Michael, I am presence. We have Archangel Sandalphon, love. We have Isis, past life. This situation involves your past life memories. We have Ishtar, boundaries. Love yourself enough to say no to others' demands on your time and energy. And you have Ishel, medicine woman. You're a channel for divine healing power. You have Use Your Hands, card number 53. You have card number 17, create art. And you have card number 49, spend time with friends. You have Fairy of the Highlands, it's time to be brave. And we have this beautiful melanated woman sitting in this field of, I don't know what kind of grass this is, but it's beautiful and it matches her dress. So we'll read that at the end. But first, let us look at the Two of Keys, the treasure, okay? So, yeah, what I'm getting from this is, like, somebody stole from this person here. So, it's like he's looking at everything like, damn, what the fuck? Like, somebody took something out of here, okay? But in the box, in the back, yeah, there's a light, right? So it's like somebody took his shit, but that was like material things, but what they didn't take was his soul, you feel me? So this is all like metaphorical, like they went through all his physical stuff and they disrespected his shit. So somebody could have tried to disrespect you this month or something along those lines, maybe stolen from you, taken something from you, right? But it's like it could be anything, but that person, they ain't got the sauce like you, you feel me? Maybe they needed it more than you did is what I hear. Maybe not, I don't know, but that's what I'm hearing. But it's like the most important thing was not touched, you feel me? Something was not touched. It was in the back and it's like glowing. It's glowing. So there's something important here. There's something important. There's something important about that. Okay, so with this energy, you have the Four of Wands, the Queen of Swords, and the Three of Pentacles. So, yeah. Four of Wands, this is like, this could either be a relationship here, okay? It could be a home situation. With the Queen of Swords. Let's see what all of this is talking about. And the Three Pentacles, so. What's the Four of Wands? Okay, you have the Hermit. You have the Six of Wands. You have Judgment. Yeah, I'm getting that inner light, letting it shine. That song is playing in my head now. All right, we have Justice. I'm getting Karmic Justice. Okay. Ten of Cups. Huh. Oh my God. Three of Cups. This is about, this could be about anything, guys. But whoever tried to take from you, they can't take your essence. Because that's something that just can't be, it can't be taken. We have the Hanged Man. I'm getting somebody stuck because of you. Because you recognized who you are. You went within and you're like, oh, this is me. It's like that treasure. You're this treasure. You're here. Like, whatever anybody tries to take from you, that's like material shit. Like, you could get it back tenfold and better, is what I'm getting. And I feel like that's something that you're needing to like realize or understand, okay? Because people could try to be copying you, or people could be trying to imitate you or whatever, but they ain't got it like you. They're not you, right? So let's see what the Queen of Swords is talking about. Okay, or maybe somebody's recognizing that about you. Like, people could try to be like you. Or maybe you're recognizing that about somebody, right? Like, people could try to be like somebody, but they would never be that person. Like, as much as they tried or as much as they wanted it to be so, like, it's just not it. Like, they don't have the same soul. Okay, or the same essence. That's the energy that I'm getting. It's like the essence. Okay, so with the Queen of Swords, we have the Nine of Pentacles. You guys, I'm getting like, all the women independent. I don't know why I'm getting that independent song by Destiny's Child. I have the Eight of Pentacles, so I'm getting like, oh, y'all are really like independent in y'all's work, how y'all work. Okay, maybe some of you guys work better alone. We have the Devil here. I wanted to say some people don't like that. Some people might be envious of how self-sufficient you are, how you can really make things work. This could be anybody, right? Somebody is jealous of somebody and how they work or like what they do. Okay, let's see what else. Okay, we have the Tower here. So this is a sudden change. We have the Knight of Wands. For some of you guys, I'm getting that once you found your independence, and for some of you guys, it was work, okay? Things suddenly changed, all right? Somebody left a situation because of this devil energy here. And so you had to leave the situation. All right, so somebody that could have left could be coming back. And you're having anxiety about that, or it's like this person leaving cause you anxiety. Okay, or maybe that's part of that devil energy, is the anxiety. We have the Ten of Pentacles, so some of you guys might be afraid of wealth, okay? Or maybe somebody is afraid of you winning or getting wealthy, or having a family or starting a family. Maybe they want this with you, or maybe you want this with somebody. We have the Princess of Pentacles, so. The seed was planted, like this was already in the works. It's just strength is needed. Courage is needed. Confidence is needed. Okay? So this is, I'm getting this is you guys then. So for some of you guys, something could be halted. Is there anything else? Yeah, something could just be halted for right now. It's like, y'all want something, but it's like you gotta recognize your worth or something like that. Know your worth and add tax. That's exactly what y'all are doing. And it's like y'all don't want any less than what y'all deserve. Okay? And that's making things change, and that's making people change. It's like now you recognize what you want, and people want to act funny, right? People want to act funny, and it's like, no, this is how I've always been. It's just, do you want better for you? You feel me? And then people want to be in and out your life, like, ugh, ugh. Some of y'all are just saying hell to the motherfucking no, okay? We have the Three of Pentacles, so let's see what the Three of Pentacles is talking about. We have the Ace of Cups with the Three of Pentacles, so yes, this is something somebody wants. We have the King of Pentacles. Okay, so this could be a business. This could be a home-based business. We have the High Priestess. So some of you guys could be working from home as High Priestesses. I may be talking to spiritual, I don't want to say spiritual warriors, but y'all could, some of y'all could be spiritual warriors, but y'all might want a spiritually based business. Okay, and this is something that you're working on. Something that will give you full control of your time, your money, whatever you want to do. Yeah, people need whatever it is that you have, okay? People need your light. That's also what I'm getting. People need your light. We have the Page of Cups. Okay, there's just something about you and your energy that is just very pure and like, people can feel you, okay? Whatever you have, it's like people need to cultivate that within themselves. So you being out there is like having them reflect on themselves, okay? Having them, yes, with the Moon card, right? Having them reflect on themselves, their emotions, their subconscious energies and feelings and thoughts, right? Because you decided to take control of your energy. We have the Hierophant. This is people walking it how they talk it. That's how I say it. But it's really people just practicing what they preach. So I feel like people are like, it's almost like being inspired by you to live in their truth, right? I see a lot of blue. So live in their truth. People need you. People need your light. They need what you have to say, whatever you're doing. Okay. This is you guys being on a platform. It's like I'm getting nobody compares. Nobody compares. You just have the spot. You have that spot. You have that spark, right? There's nobody like you. Nobody can come for your spot, right? They may try to, but no weapon formed against you shall prosper. And I'm speaking that shit. All right. At the bottom of the deck, we have the Empress. All right. So we have Archangel Raphael, empathy. Okay. Archangel Michael, I am presence, and Sandalphon, or Archangel Sandalphon, love. All right. So empathy. I feel like for this month, you will need empathy. Okay. Or need to empathize with certain people, okay, or whatever they're going through. And maybe not even feeling sorry for somebody, it's just like feeling for them, like, I understand what you're going through. And maybe just not fucking with it. Or maybe some of you guys are fucking with certain people, okay? And okay, we have Archangel Michael, I am presence. So I'm getting, yeah, you are who you are. And I feel like that's a lot of like that light energy. You are the light. You are who you are, right? It's like no one can change that. Like, as I feel like you're not allowing somebody or anyone to change who you are and what like you do or anything like that, right? And so you have Archangel Sandalphon, love. So I'm getting like people love you. Okay, and you love others. It's something about the way you love, you have, it's it can be felt even through the screen. It can be felt from miles away is what I'm getting. All right, and okay, so you have Archangel, you have Isis, past life, the situation involves your past life memories. So some of you guys this month could be going through a situation where it could be in love, it could be anything, right? But it's like somebody may have taken from you, maybe even taking your time, right? Because time, I'm gonna get into time in a different video, but time is it's almost like a source of currency, and somebody may have taken that from you here on this earthly plane, right? And there was a lesson to be learned from that, okay? So this month, you guys will be going through a lesson that maybe you have gone through in a past life, or maybe you've gone through in this life. We have Ishtar, boundaries. Love yourself enough to say no to others' demands on your time and energy. So yeah, some of you guys, okay, some of y'all might be dealing with energy vampires, okay, energy drainers. You can love them from afar, okay? You can love them from a distance, is what I'm getting. Put up your boundaries, yes. Have your protection amulets, yes, okay? Or maybe this is something that you've been through before, right? We have Ishel, medicine woman. You're a channel for divine healing power, so I definitely feel like some of you guys are healing from maybe that energy if you guys went through that in the past. Okay, I get a lot of you guys are healers. You guys are very loving. That's probably the reason why people can feel you through the screen or through whatever work that you do. They can feel your soul. They can feel how you heal. So put that energy out there, okay? Put your light out there. Put your truth out there. We have Fairy of the Highlands, it's time to be brave, card number 20. So From this card, I'm getting that things seem to be very cold and bleak for some, or you know a way to combat that. There's something you have to say. There's a truth that you have. The sword. It's like you guys need to be brave and speak up. Like, don't be timid. Like, speak your truth, because you have the truth in your hands. You are the truth. You're the walking truth, right? In this seemingly cold world, you can make the world so warm with your love. You feel me? There's other people like you too, is what I'm getting. But yeah, there's something about your truth, but it's like you just need to be brave about it. Some of y'all might want to watch Paul 1, because we got some of the same energy for them too. It kind of sounds like similar. All right, so y'all have Use Your Hands, card number 53. So to take care of yourselves this month, use your hands, create. I get a lot of you guys are very creative and artistic. We have Create Art. Yeah, a lot of you guys are artistic. And then you have Spend Time With Friends this month. So that would be fun, spending time with different people, reading tarot cards, eating good food, having good conversations, right? Some of you guys could be like doing some of your healing work for your friends this month, right? Or maybe some of y'all are cutting back on that. Okay, no, I'm getting boundaries. Okay, some of you guys want to do this, but it's like you guys are afraid of your boundaries being crossed. Just protect yourselves, okay? Carry your amulets, all that stuff, you'll be fine. You'll be fine. Nobody's going to fuck with your energy, okay? And then we have this beautiful melanated woman. It says, let all distractions... Sorry, y'all, I got a call, but... Alright, it says, let all distractions flow by, concentrate on the things you really want. Concentrate on the things you really want. Alright, so yeah, that's from the Let Go Oracle deck. So that's what you need to let go of this month, is all distractions. And concentrate on the things you really want, okay? So yeah, that's all I have for you. Pile 2. I love you guys so much, and I'll talk to y'all later. What's up, Pile 3? So let's see what you guys got this month. So you have card number 20, Will, Wisdom, and Mind. Oh, wow. Okay, with the Triquetra. Oh, how crazy. I knew this was going to be my pile. My ring got a Triquetra on it too. That's crazy. All right. Will, Wisdom, and Mind. Okay. You have Queen of Cups, Six of Cups, and the Nine of Wands. And I will be going a little deeper in each of these cards with the Mystic Mondays tarot deck. So we have Archangel Jophiel Joy, Archangel Raziel Dreams, Archangel Sandalphon Intention. Okay, you have Coventina Purification. Yeah, so I was telling the other two groups that I forgot to take out all the books that I needed for this reading for the month, but I was getting, they wanted me to just read it intuitively, and so far it's been fucking dope. Look, we have the triple knot again. This is crazy. Wow. And this girl in the water will read this at the very end, okay? So yeah. Yeah, we'll go into those cards later. Because I've been talking a lot with the other two, and I don't know. With y'all, it's like, get to the point. I get the energy, just get to it. So, oh, yes, this is, some of you guys could be Irish, Celtic, okay? Might have Druid blood, okay? We have fire. What is this, earth, water? Okay, those are the three elements. This is dope. This is so dope. But yeah, those are the three elements. I'm seeing three legs. Will, wisdom, and mind. I'm getting root, heart, throat. I'm also getting like fire, earth. Yeah, fire, earth, water. I really thought it was earth, water, and air because of the three realms. But there's something about the fire. There's something about the fire for this one. Okay. So will is the solar plexus, wisdom. Okay, the crown, mind. That's air. Okay. So maybe even throat. Okay, I'm just looking at that. But it's like you guys are using all of that this month. There's something about you guys coming into some type of divine balance. Okay, it's like it's locked in. I'm getting it. It's locked in. You're locked in. You've been locked in. All right, let's see. Okay, we got the Queen of Cups. Let's slow down. So Queen of Cups, Six of Cups, Nine of Wands. Going back in time. Past, present, future energy here. Nine of Wands. Nine of Wands. Yeah, there's some type of like blockage here. And I'm getting it's connected with the will. I'm looking at solar plexus energy. So you guys could be working on your solar plexus this month. Let's see what the Queen of Cups is talking about. We have the Queen of Cups again. So this could be like your intuition just popping, right? You're really in tune with your emotions this month is what I'm getting here. Six of Cups. There's something about like a soulmate as well. But we'll get into Six of Cups later. All right, so. With the Queen of Cups, we have the Wheel of Fortune. Okay, so you guys intuitively feel this change. And it's a positive change. You guys have been really loving yourselves. And both of these cards, they're both looking at this cup. And both of the Queen of Cups. They're both looking at their cup. And they're just happy with what they have in their cup. I feel like a lot of you guys are happy with yourselves. Or like, there's something emotionally fulfilling for you guys. I'm also getting, yes, spiritual baths. Oops. You have the Eight of Cups. So, you guys are going to be walking away from something here. What the fuck? Here. Some of y'all might be walking away from something here. Or let's see, let's go a bit deeper. Maybe you guys feel like that, you feel like you have to, or you feel something changing here. What is changing? We have the Knight of Pentacles. Ten of Wands. This could also be emotionally detaching from something here. In order for something to come in, I'm getting like manifestation energy, most definitely. We have the Seven of Wands. So, what are you walking away from? It's like there's something that's been slow growing that you've been putting a lot of work and effort into. okay? With the Seven of Wands, it's like there could be competition or like other people doing the same thing as you. This is moving forward from that. You have the High Priestess. That's that intuitive energy, that feminine wisdom. Strength. Ooh. All right, we have the Five of Wands. There's something going on here. There's a conflicting path, I'm feeling. We have the Two of Wands. The Five of Wands. Strength in conflict. You guys have to emotionally detach from a situation. This could be anything. This could even be a job from a situation, like a relationship. But it's like you have to, in order for this wheel to change, for this wheel to turn, you have to step away from something like emotionally, because it's like there's something, it's like it's growing, or it was an offer, and it's like the work that you're putting in, nobody really compares, or nobody's doing the same thing as you are. So I'm getting like you moving forward here, and needing the strength to move forward. Okay. It's like you already know that you'll have to like deal with some shit, or like people trying to fight it. All right, but there's something about your path. Like, this is just your path. Is there anything else you'd like to say before I move on? Okay. We have the Death card. And we have the Page of Swords. So, yeah, I'm getting a transformation here. A change in mindset. Changing how you think. Okay. Some of you guys could be really wanting to tap more into your spirituality, have something more spiritual based, but it's like, it's that conflict. And I feel like part of that conflict is, like, are you willing to transform how you think about something here? Maybe even about how you think about yourself or what makes you happy. So let's see what the Six of Cups is. Goodness. We have the Nine of Swords. So this is sleepless nights about something or someone, or maybe you guys are picking up on this from somebody. We have the Page of Pentacles. What is this Page of Pentacles? We have the Sun. And we have the Eight of Pentacles. There might be a change or a move this month that some of you guys are very anxious about, okay? Some of you guys might be anxious about, will you find a job? Will you be happy? Okay? We have the World card. So, I'm getting a cycle here. Maybe you guys are entering a new cycle. new world. This is different for you guys. Okay. We have the Lovers here. So I'm getting soulmate energy as well.
Okay.
And we have the King of Swords. This is about making a decision and sticking with it, using your mind, being logical about something. I'm also getting Gemini energy. We have the Knight of Cups. All right, is there anything else? Somebody will be offering you something this month. We have the Ten of Cups. All right, so I'm getting that whatever this person is offering you is genuine. You'll be very happy. Okay, anything else? This is spiritual fulfillment. You'll be very spiritually fulfilled. And with the Six of Pentacles, there's an energy of like an equal giving and receiving. Okay? It's like you guys are gonna share everything. This is your soulmate. And to be with them, you have to change. Or you have to become whole within self. And then there's something about like past, present, and future. There's something about like blockages. So let's see what this Nine of Wands is. Okay, we have the Hanged Woman. So there's something about stagnation. Maybe I'm getting lethargy. So some of you guys could have been really lethargic because of maybe blockages. Yeah, Four of Swords, sleeping a lot, getting rest. Maybe you guys needed the rest. Yeah, some of y'all really needed the rest. We have the Queen of Swords. We have the Eight of Wands. Okay. I feel like you got, this was a much needed rest. I'm getting standoffish energy. Maybe you guys kept people at arm's length. Okay. We have the Hierophant here. So I'm getting an energy of something coming quickly. Maybe quickly understanding certain concepts here. Something that's gonna help cut you down. Okay, this is about how to heal yourself with the Temperance card. Okay, this is about how to heal yourself. What else? We have the Hierophant. I mean, the Emperor. Wow, the Hierophant. We already have the Hierophant. Okay, so, and then the Devil. Okay, this is healing toxic masculinity. This is like, I'm getting patriarchy. There's something about the patriarchy, right? It's like some of you guys are understanding that. I'm channeling like right now, I'm channeling like a strong female or strong feminine energy that doesn't want to be tied down or like bogged down or something like that. She might have walked away from the situation, said no to something because of how restrictive it was to her and her energy. I'm getting, yeah, like your willpower was really fucked up. Or for some of you guys, this could have been a toxic masculine in your life that really fucked with your willpower, okay? Maybe you guys didn't believe you could have or do certain things, all right? But I feel like a lot of y'all were very strong-willed, maybe even growing up. Even now, like, you could be looked at as defiant or something like that, or just going against certain shit, but it's like, you're saying no to toxic masculinity. You're saying no to, I don't know, I'm getting like the patriarchy or something like that, right? But I'm also getting that there's something toxic that you're saying no to. So for some of you guys, this could be a toxic pattern that may have came from your father. So I'm just getting like, because we have the Hierophant, we have the Emperor. So yeah, some of y'all had to say no to something or stop a cycle is what I'm getting. It's like ending a cycle here. I'm getting even a cycle of abuse, and this could be abuse of anything, abusing something or abusing someone. Okay, you could have been abused, or you could have been the abuser. Okay, it's like you're realizing that something has to change within you in order for this cycle to change, and that has to deal with your solar plexus, your will, your wisdom, and your mind. We have the King and the Queen of Swords. All right, wow, y'all's reading is powerful as fuck. Powerful as fuck. You guys have been through a lot. You guys have been through a lot, but your hard work is finally going to pay off. Okay, so we have Archangel Jophiel, Joy. So I'm getting this month, they want you to be in the energy of joy. Okay, that's also solar plexus energy. That's the high vibrational energy of the solar plexus. So be in that energy of joy. That's going to attract a lot more things into your spirit, into your world. Okay, you have Archangel Raziel, dreams. So for some of you guys, this month your dreams may be very telling, may be very vivid. Okay, some of you guys could be sleeping a lot, or you need to sleep a lot more. Okay, maybe work on that third eye, the upper chakras. Okay. And then we have Archangel Sandalphon in intention. I thought it said intuition. Intention. So what I'm getting from this month is to do everything with intention as much as you possibly can. Be in the present. Okay, do everything intentionally, on purpose. Okay, I think it's like you can do it now is what I'm getting. It's like you can do it now. All right, so we have Clementina, purification. It's time for a cleansing, detoxification of your body and mind. Right, there's a lot about the mind. Here we have the mind, right? We have the King and the Queen of Swords. The mind, that's part of the air element of this triquetra, right? So this is purification of this up, like I said, the upper chakras. So your third eye, your crown chakra. Okay, so purifying those parts of you, maybe even setting an intention when you take a spiritual bath to cleanse and purify negative thoughts, behaviors, patterns, so on and so forth. Okay, and we have Mary Magdalene, unconditional love. Love yourself, others, in every situation, no matter what the outward appearances may be. Okay, so yeah, they just want you to have love for like everything and everyone, right? And I feel like that's what you guys are going to be having this month. You guys are going to be tapped into this Mary Magdalene energy of feeling a lot of love, loving others, loving every situation. You know what I'm saying? Gaining wisdom from each situation. And then we have bodies of water, Sulis. Spend time near water, such as a lake, river, or the ocean, to recharge your batteries. So some of you guys may be spending time near water, maybe. Some of you guys may live near water, or may meditate near water, right? The element of water is very prevalent for you guys this month. So also drink a lot of water. All right, so we have card number 22. This is how to take care of yourselves this month. We have card number 22, energy work. So yeah, like I was saying, those chakras that I was talking about, right? Oh, the sliding, those chakras. So your third eye. Come on, lighting. Your third eye and your crown. We've got the solar plexus here, right? So doing some energy work this month is very important for you guys. And then we have card number 42, read. If you want to be part of the book club this month, let me know. We're doing that right now on Instagram. That's funny that I'm telling you guys that, but because I forgot to tell the other groups that. So maybe somebody in here is in my book club. So hey, if you're in my book club, what's up, Paul 3? But if not, yeah, follow me on Instagram. We're doing a book club this month. And we're reading a book that's definitely going to help with the mind, like, most definitely. And then we have card number 36, movement. I'm getting moving energy. So some of y'all might be moving this month, but I'm also getting, some of y'all might be moving because the energy will be better for you. Maybe y'all will be moving near water, okay? But I'm also getting to maybe move near water, like actually like do yoga near water or run near water. Okay, take a walk near water. Okay, movement, just move. All right, and then, okay, we have strangely lonely, holding on way too tightly. Card number 17, and she has another Celtic cross, so yeah. Well, another Celtic cross. It looks like a Celtic cross, but she has Celtic knots on there. Strangely lonely, holding on way too tightly. So spirit is saying to let go. There's something that you need to let go of. Okay. Holding on way too tightly. Maybe you guys are holding on way too tight onto something and you need to let go of something because it's holding you back. That could be part of the Nine of Wands energy. Right? You're holding on to something and you need to let it go, right? This could even be holding on to someone and you need to let it go. Or maybe somebody from your past, maybe they visit you in your dreams, okay? Okay. Or maybe somebody's holding on to you still. Yeah, you need to let go. This month is like, they want you to let go. They want you to let go. Yeah, with the Eight of Cups, I was like, let go. Holding on way too tightly. This could have been something that you put a lot of like time and energy into. Right, and made sure that you were on top, but they want you to let something go. It's y'all are finna move forward or something like that, and holding on to a place or situation or people is only going to cause more conflict within you because you'll be confused about like where to go or about your path. So yeah, something has to end in order for you guys to really be on your path. All right, and then we have this lady bathing in the water. It says, let go of yesterday. This is what she needs to let go of. Sorry, this is from the Let Go Tarot. Let go of yesterday as what you do right now is more important. So yeah, most definitely, like I said, I think I just say that, but staying in the present. Right, whatever you're doing now has an effect on like your future. So yeah, it's like past, present, future, right? Yesterday past, it's like let go of what had happened in the past, because whatever you're doing in the present is directly affecting your future, right? And I feel like a lot of you guys are coming into that realization. So putting the work in, whatever actions or whatever was done in the past, you know, I'm just getting like actions, like things being done. right? Let go of yesterday, as what you do right now is more important. So yeah, forget about yesterday, forget about the past, you know what I'm saying? This month, you might wanna just start over and do better for yourself, you feel me? So yeah, that's what I'm getting for you guys for the month of February. I love you guys so much, and I will talk to you later.